students, welcome to our YouTube channel Physics Fact. Here we discuss about reflection in spherical mirror. This is the fourth part of optics and optical instrument.
Reflection in spherical mirror. A spherical mirror is a part of a hollow sphere whose one side is reflecting surface and other side is opaque. That means other side is silver polished surface. Then the spherical mirror is two type. One is concave mirror, another one is convex mirror. In case of concave mirror, the outer bulb surface is the silver polished surface, whereas inner hollow surface reflection takes place. In case of convex mirror, outer bulb surface reflection takes place, whereas inner hollow surface is silver polished surface. That means in case of concave mirror, reflection takes place in inner hollow surface, whereas in case of convex mirror, reflection takes place in outer bulb surface. Now let's take a spoon. Here what happened? The inner hollow surface, if the inner hollow surface, here reflection takes place, whereas bulb surface silver polished surface, then here this mirror is called as concave mirror. Take another condition. Here, if the outer bulb surface, here reflection takes place, whereas inner hollow surface is silver polished surface, then this type of mirror is called as convex mirror. Now we go to some important term of the spherical mirror. What is the important terms? First one, pole. The middle point of the mirror is called as pole. The center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part, that center of the sphere is called as center of curvature. The line which passing through pole and center of curvature, that line is called as principal axis. Okay, that line is called as principal axis. The distance between pole to center of curvature, that is called as the radius of curvature, and that is denoted by R. Or the radius of the sphere of which the mirror is a part, that radius is also known as radius of curvature. And that radius of curvature, that radius is always perpendicular to the surface of the mirror. Now, the line which joining the two end part of the mirror, that means the line which joining A and B, that line is called as aperture. That means here, if we take a spoon and draw an imaginary line from the up and down point, from up point to down, that line is called as aperture of the mirror. Okay, that line is called as aperture of the mirror. Now we go to what is focus. A beam of light parallel to the principal axis falls on a concave mirror after reflection. The reflected ray are converge and meet at a point. Here, that point is called as focus. In case of concave mirror, the reflected ray are converges. So concave mirror is also known as converging mirror. Whereas in case of convex mirror, the beam of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection, they are diverges, but appears to come from one point. That point is called as focus. Here in case of convex mirror, the ray are diverge, so convex mirror is also known as diverging mirror. Here that focus produced, that is the real focus, whereas in case of convex mirror, the focus produced, that is the virtual focus. Now the distance between focus to pole, this distance is known as focal length. This distance is known as focal length. Now go to some important figure in figure 1. If a ray AB, that is the incident ray, if that incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, after reflection it goes through focus, rule 1. Then second one, if the incident ray goes through focus, AB is the incident ray and passes through focus, after reflection it goes parallel to the principal axis. Now the third one, if any incident ray passes through center of curvature, there is no deviation occur and that ray is retrace its own path, or if ray is this one GP is any incident ray and passes through center of curvature, that ray is retrace its path. Okay, now another point, if any incident ray passes through a pole, at that condition it obeys laws of reflection. Here angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection, and here that PC is the reflected ray, obey laws of reflection. Students, remember this four figure which is used in our next topic, that is we determine the mirror formula for spherical mirror. Now here we derive the relation between focal length and radius of curvature. Now we take a concave mirror, also convex mirror. Take a ray AB, which is parallel to the principal axis, After reflection, the reflected ray is passes through focus in case of concave mirror, whereas in case of convex mirror, that ray AB is parallel to the principal axis but in a diverge, but appears to comes from focus. Now the distance between focus to pole, this distance is called as focal length, and the distance between center of curvature to pole, that distance is called as radius of curvature. We determine the relation between focal length and radius of curvature. At point B, we draw normal and joint with C. That is the radius of curvature of this concave and convex mirror. This one is the radius of curvature. Yes, distance from center of curvature to that mirror, this one is the radius of curvature. Also, perpendicular to the surface of the mirror. Now, what happened here, students? This one is the normal, and according to laws of reflection, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Here also, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Now, go to the geometric form and we determine the relation between focal length and radius of curvature. First one, here for concave mirror, angle ABC is equal to CBF, that is angle I is equal to angle R. According to laws of reflection, ABC equals to CBF. Now, as AB is parallel to CP, then ABC is equal to BCF, this two angle. Okay, ABC is equal to BCF. So what happened? CBF is equal to BCF. CBF is equal to BCF. That means this two angle is also similar. So as BCF is equal to CBF, that means that CF is equal to BF. CF is equal to BF. And here what happened? That mirror is very small aperture that B is very near it to P. What happens to that? That mirror is very small aperture, so that B point is very near it to P. As B is very close to P, B is very close to P, BF is also equal to PF. Okay. As B is nearly equal to P, BF is equal to PF. Okay. As BF is equal to PF, that means CF is equal to PF. Okay. BF is equal to PF, that means CF is equal to also PF. Now, the radius of curvature, that is PC. So, PC equals to CF plus PF. So, as CF is equal to PF, PC is equal to 2 times of PF. What is PC? That is radius of curvature. That is equal to 2 times of focal length. Okay?
Similarly, we can determine the relation between focal length and radius of curvature for convex mirror. In case of convex mirror, the ray is deviated but appears to come from focus. Joint CB, that is the normal. Next, the procedure of convex mirror as similar as the concave mirror. You all try it.
Now students, we discuss the sign convention. This one is most important topic and used in numericals. So students, concentrate it. First one, here we use sign for object distance, image distance, also for focal length. That means if here we take an object, then the distance between object to pole, this distance is known as object distance. Now, here image is produced. Assume that here image is produced. Then the distance between image to pole, the distance is called as image distance. So, how we use the sign? In which case the sign is positive and which case that sign is negative? Okay? So, first one students, we take measurement or the distance is measured from the pole, from pole to object or from pole to image. We always take measurement from pole. The measured distance, if we go along the direction of the incident ray, take us, this one is the object and this one is the incident ray. If we take measurement along the direction of the incident ray, then this measurement is taken as positive. While if in the opposite direction of the incident ray we measure the distance, then that distance is taken as negative. That means here when we calculate the object distance, we take measurement from pole to object. That means here that distance we measure, that is in opposite direction of the incident ray. So that object distance is taken as negative. Whereas when we measure the image distance, we take measurement from pole to image. That means that distance is along the direction of the incident ray. When we take measurement, that is along the direction of the incident ray. So here that image distance is taken as positive. Whereas if image is produced here, then what is the sign convention for image distance? Here we take measurement for image, that is from pole to image. Pole to image, that means in opposite direction of incident ray. So in this case that image distance is taken as negative. You clear students? The height measured from upward of the principal axis or above the principal axis, that height is taken as positive. Whereas the height which we measure below the principal axis, that height is taken as negative. Take as your object height, that is HO, and image height, that is HI. Here HO, that is above the principal axis or upward from the principal axis, so this one is positive, and height of the image, that is downward the principal axis or below the principal axis, so height is taken as negative. Clear, students? Or if we take this mirror is our y prime plane, and that principal axis is the xy plane, then what happened here, students? This one is origin, or that pole is take as 0, this one 1, 2, 3, 4, like this one is the positive coordinate, and this one -1, -2, -3, like this one is the negative side. So the measurement which we take in this direction or right side of the mirror, that all is positive sign, and which are in left side of the mirror, that all are in negative sign. Likewise, in y-axis, this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, and this one -1, -2, -3, -4. So above the principal axis, that is taken as positive, whereas below the principal axis, that is taken as negative. You remember this one, and also remember this one for easiness, okay?